One of the strangest stories I've ever heard happened this week with Jeffrey Earnhardt. The press release went out from Rick Ware Racing at the beginning of this week that said you were out of the ride, and then you responded and said, I'm not shopping sponsors. Give us the update of just how hard it is to keep a deal going in truck racing today.
Oh, it's tough. You know, it's a lot of miscommunications whenever, you know, the driver and the owner don't stay in contact real well. And that's what it came down to. I called Rick up and we worked it out. And, you know, we got to where we're going to work through this race. And, you know, he's supplying with a real good truck and we're excited to be here. Just trying to work to find sponsors to keep going. It's definitely not easy these days with the economy, but, you know, we're going to bust our butts to make sure we can find something.
All right. We wish you good luck. Hope to see you in Nashville. The rumor down here in the garage is that Jeffrey will be in Nashville, but not for sure in what ride, and that Fuel Doctor will not be back on the number one truck at our next race. Now, if you have questions for any of us on the broadcast crew, you can reach us on Twitter. You can reach us at NCWTS on speed, and that way you can send us a good question. Now, let's get to the question, which is from Jenny Penny. She wants to know, is there anybody in this field today that can beat Kevin Harvick and Kyle Busch? Well, guess what, Jenny? The answer last year in the fall was Ron Hornaday. He was able to do it, and there's a couple other guys real good. I think Johnny Sauter might be another one that can contend with those Cup regulars. Krista?
All right, thanks, Ray. My question was what exactly that art project became, but maybe we'll get that answer a little bit later.